Hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to continue our DMAS rules questions. Let us try 2.3 questions. It's word problems. First question, question number 2. A factory employs 100 workers. In a factory there are 100 workers. Of these, 36 workers earn a wage of 410 rupees per day. Out of that, 36 workers and 36 workers and 410 rupees per day. And the rest of the employees earn a wage of 360 rupees per day. If the factory runs for 6 days in a week, how much does it pay each week? In this question, we can see there are so many sub questions. First one, that is, they gave in a factory there are 100 workers. That is a given thing. And of these, 36 workers earn 410 rupees. Then the rest earn a wage of 360. The number of workers earn 360 rupees is, how will you find? We need to find the rest of the employees earn a wage of 360 rupees. The number, the rest, that means the number, total number of workers, that is 100, and 36 workers earn 410, and the remaining employees earn 360 rupees. Remaining, the number of remaining, how will you find it one? The total is 100, and the 36 out of that 136 workers earn 410 rupees, and the rest of that, that means 100 minus 36, that is 64. That means 64 workers earn 360 per day. 36 workers earn rupees 410 per day, and 64 workers earn 360 per day. Now we need to find, if the factory runs for 6 days in a week, how much does it pay each week? We need to find the total amount that the company or the factory needs to pay for the workers. The first thing, that is, 36 workers earn 410 per day. That means the amount they gave for 36 workers is equal to, how will you find? For one worker, they gave 410 rupees. For 36, it is 36 into 410. For 36 workers, they gave the amount 410 per day. For the 36 workers, the total amount they gave for it, 36 into 410. 36 into 410. So we multiply with 41. 1 into 6, 6. 1 into 3, 3. 6 into 4, 24. Carry over 2. 4 into 3 is 12 plus 2, 14. Answer is 6, 7, 4, 1. Then the first 0. Write the 0 here. So the answer is 14,760. So the factory gave 14,760 rupees for 36 workers. In the question, they gave 36 workers in 410 per day. That means out of these 36, one worker in 410 rupees. For 36, it is 410 into 36, that is 14,760. And then they gave the others, the rest, and a wage of 360 rupees per day. That means 64 workers and 360 per day. So the total amount that they need for 64 workers is 464. That is equal to 64 into 360. So we need to multiply 64 into 360. That is equal to what we do? We multiply 64 into 36, then finally we place 0 in the answer. 6 into 4, 24. So write 4 here, 24, 4, 2 is the carry over. 6 into 6, 36 plus 2, 38. Place 0, then multiply 3 into 4, 12, carry over. 1, 3, 6 are 18 plus 1, 19. 4 plus 0, 4. 8 plus 2, 10, carry over. 1, 4 plus 9, 13, carry over. 1, 1 plus 1, 2, and place the 0. So the answer is 23,040. So the factory gave 23,040 rupees for 64 employees and 14,760 rupees for 36 employees. So for 100 employees they gave, the total amount they gave for one day, that is equal to total amount for one day, amount need for one day, that is equal to this 14,760 plus 23,040, that is equal to, we need to add the given numbers. When we add these two numbers, then we get 14,760 plus 23,040, that is equal to 0 plus 0, 0, 4 plus 6, 10, carry over 1, 7 plus 1, 8, 4 plus 1, 7, 2 plus 1, 3. Answer is 37 rupees, 37,800. That means the company needs 37,800 rupees for one day. For one day, they gave 37 rupees 800. Then, how will you find the amount that they need for 6 days? If for one day they need 37,800, so for 6 days it is, we for 6 days we need to, what we do for finding the amount they need to pay for 6 days, that is equal to, yes, we need to multiply for 6 days, it is 6 into the amount 37,800, multiply 378 with 6, 6 8s are 48, carry over 4, 6 into 7, 42, 42 plus 4, 46, carry over 4, 6 into 3, 18 plus 4, 22, then place 2 zeros, these 2 zeros, the answer is 2,26,800. So the total amount that the company need to pay for the 100 workers in 6 days, that is equal to 2,26,800. Once more I will tell, in the question they gave there are 100 workers in a company. Out of that they gave 410 for each, for the, they gave 410 rupees per day for 36 workers, and then the rest earn a wage of 360 per day. We need to find if the factory rents for 6 days in a week, how much does it pay each week? It's our question. So first step is, first we need to find the wages for 36 workers. They gave, they 36 workers earn a wage of 410 rupees per day. That means for 36 workers it is 36 into 410. It is equal to 14,760. Then they gave the wages for 64 workers, that is the rest, 100 minus 36, that is 64. So the wages for 64 workers is equal to 64 into 360, that is equal to 23,040. Then we find the total amount that they gave in one day. That is equal to this. We need to add this to 14,760 plus 23,040. That is equal to 37,800. That is the amount they gave for one day. For finding the amount need for 6 days is equal to 6 into that amount. 6 into 37,800. That is equal to 2,26,800. Here question have 3 sub questions, so carefully we need to do. Next question, let us try 2.3. question number 3. Jai has rupees 4,500. In Jack's hand there is 4,500 rupees. He spends rupees 2,100. Out of that 4,500, he spent 2,100 rupees and divides the remaining amount. Then after spending 2,100 rupees, he got some amount left that he divides into 4 equal parts. Then he saves one part and spends the other 3 parts. Out of that 4 parts, he saves one part and spends the other 3 parts. He receives an amount of rupees 400 from his aunt as a token of gift. Find the amount of money he has now. No, question is very tough, but it is simple. When we see the question is value. It's very big, but it is simple. We can read. Once more, we can read. Jai has rupees 4,500. The first thing that they given, that is Jai has rupees 4,500. We write there. Now Jack's hand, there is 4,500 rupees. And he spent 2,100. He spent 2,100 from this. That is equal to, that means we need to subtract. Answer is, when we subtract 4,500 minus 2,100 is equal to 0042. That is 2,400. Now Jack's answer is 2,400 rupees. Then this much is over. Then, and divides the remaining amount into 4 equal parts. That means he divides this amount into 4 equal parts. That means divide by 4. If you divide 2,400 by 4, then we get 24 by 4. Which number? 24 by 4. 4 into 6 is 24. 0, 0. Remaining 2 zeros right there. So answer is 600. When he divides the remaining amount into 4 equal parts, each part is 600. So this much is over. Then he saves one part and spends other part, 3 parts. He save one part. One part is 600 rupees. One part equal to 600 rupees. And he spent other 3 parts. That is not our problem. He spent it. Now the remaining amount in his hand is 600 rupees. He saves only 600 rupees and he spent other 3 parts. That means 600. 4 600s are here. 4 600s. 2,400. When we divide 2,400 into 4 equal parts, then we get 4,600. He spends the other 3 parts and he only saves 600 rupees. That is, now in his hand there is 600 rupees. Now in his hand there is only 600 rupees. This much is over. Then he receives an amount of rupees 400 from his aunt as a token of gift. His aunt gave 400 rupees. Now in his aunt there is 600 rupees. Then after that aunt gave 400 rupees. He got, that means he added 400 rupees in his. So now in his aunt there is 600 plus 400, that is 1,000. Find the amount of money he has now. Now in his hand there is 1,000 rupees. Question solved. It's simple. Once more I will tell. Here, initial amount in his hand, that is 4,500, we all know. Then he spent 2,100 rupees out of from 4,500, that is amount left after spend rupees 2,100 is equal to 4,500 minus 2,100, that is equal to 2,400. Now in his hand there is 2,400 rupees. Then he divides that into four equal parts. When we divide 2,400 into four equal parts, then we get 600, 600, 600, 600. Then next one is he saves one part and spend the other three parts. Amount left after spend three parts of 2,400, that is 2,400 minus 3,600, that is 1,800. Answer is 600. Now in his hand there is only 600 rupees. This much is over. Then he receives an amount of rupees 400 from his aunt as a token of gift. Then he got 400 rupees. That means now the amount in his hand is 600 plus 400, that is equal to 1000. Now the next question. Susan had rupees 350. Susan had 350 rupees. She withdraw rupees 2000 from her bank account. She withdraw 2000 rupees from the bank. Then she and bought shirt for rupees 340, t-shirt for rupees 160 each, and two pair of socks for rupees 54 each. Find the money left with her. There is one mistake in the question. The question, there is, she bought two t-shirts. This one mistake is there. The question is, two t-shirts. She bought two t-shirts for rupees 160 each and two pairs of socks for rupees 54 each. Find the money left with her. The question is, there are so many parts, so we can write. Start right. First, Susan had rupees 350. Initially, in her hand there is 350 rupees. Then she withdraw rupees 2000 from her bank. That means she got rupees 2000. That means she added 2000. Now in her hand there is 2350 rupees. Okay. Then she bought a shirt for rupees 340. The cost for the shirt, that is equal to 340. Then she bought two t-shirts for rupees 160 each. That means one t-shirt cost rupees 160. So for two t-shirt, it is 2 into 160, that is equal to 320. Then she bought two pairs of socks for rupees 54 each. Then she bought two socks. Each socks cost 54 rupees. So two amount for two socks is equal to 2 into 54, that is equal to 108. First she bought 340 rupees shirt, then 320 rupees two t-shirt, then she gave 108 rupees. We need to find the money left with her. So we know in her hand there is 2,350 rupees. First she buy a shirt for 340, that means she spent 340 from this one. Then the remaining amount is 2010. When we subtract 340 from 350, that is 2010. Then she bought She spent 320 rupees. That means 2010 minus 320. 0, 1 minus 2 is not possible. It is 11. It become 9. It is 1. 11 minus 2, 9. 9 minus 3, 6. 1. The remaining amount is after spend 320 rupees in her hand, 1690 is left. Then she bought socks. She spent 108 rupees. That means 1690 minus 108. That is equal to 0 minus 8 is not possible. Take 1 from here, it becomes 8, it becomes 10. 10 minus 8, 2. 8 minus 0, 8. 6 minus 1, 5. 1. So the remaining amount in her hand, that is equal to 1582. The final amount, that is 1582. Once more I will tell. Susan had rupees 350. Initial amount 350. Then she withdraw 2000 rupees from the account. Amount after withdraw, that is equal to 2350. Then she bought shirt for 340. Then cost for two t-shirt is equal to 320. Cost for two pairs of socks is equal to 108. So the amount that she spent is equal to, we need to add these three numbers. When we add these three numbers, 340 plus 320 plus 108 is equal to 768. That is the total amount she spent. In her hand there is 2350 rupees. She spent 768. Then the remaining amount is equal to 2350 minus 768 is equal to 1582. Today we discuss some weight problems. They have the four operations. In a question, it have four operations together. Then what we do? We need to do the question using DMAS. Always think we need to use DMAS rule. D for division, M for multiplication, then addition, then subtraction. First do division, then multiplication, then addition, and finally subtraction. So see you in the next class. Thank you.